Superman?
It's not Superman. Do you bet that they know or they don't know?
I bet they know.
All right.
I hope they know.
I hope so too. I'm going on a limb here. I'm going to try Nick Fury, Agent of S.H.I.E.L.D.
No. What do you think, Ron?
I think it's Black Widow.
No, I'm afraid both those are all wrong. Is it the Hulk, Iron Man, or Spider-Man?
I'll say Spider-Man.
What do you think, guys? I know you know Spider-Man. Does he fight a guy named Spymaster?
Don't recall one. I'm gonna go with Iron Man.
They're both saying Iron Man. Do you want to change your choice? You said Spider Man. The two guys here are saying Iron Man. What do you want to take?
I'll take Iron Man.
Iron Man is the correct answer.
Oh, good. At least I got a point.
And that's it. Yes, you are.
Now, for the record, I'll just go like this.
Okay, thank you very much, Steve.
All right.
Okay,
take
bye-bye.
Care.
Bye-bye. And good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Tiger. How are you?
I'm great. Janet, how are you?
I'm fine. Thank you so much. Hi, guys.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you.
Excellent.
Are you ready for your question?
Yes, I am.
All right. The comedian, Dr. Manhattan, and Rorschach. Were all characters in which acclaimed 1986 DC Comics miniseries?
I don't have a clue.
Do you bet that they know or they don't know?
Probably not.
You're betting that they don't know?
No, yes, that's it. They don't know.
We don't know?
All right, so what do you have as an answer?
I got The Watchmen.
The Watchmen by Alan Moore.
The Watchmen.
Oh, excuse me.
I'm sorry, Janet, they did know.
Oh, good. That's okay. No problem.
All right.
You have a nice weekend, all of you guys.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye. Okay, we'll take one more player, and then we'll start overtime after a music break. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hello, Cat. Randy and Ron.
Hello.
Hi, Doug.
Hi.
How are you?
Not too bad, thanks.
You ready for your question?
I'll try it.
All right. 4 decades after his creation, what was the thing's religion revealed to be? And remember, the guess is free. What religion was the thing?
I don't know.
Well, take a guess on a religion, any religion.
Buddhist.
It's not Buddhist. And you want to bet that they know or they don't know?
Yeah, I'll say they know.
They know. All right.
I'm going to go Jewish.
Jewish.
They're both saying Jewish, and that is correct. Jewish for 2 points, Doug.
Oh, yeah. Okay, Chad.
Hey, thanks for playing.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Bye. Bye-bye. I don't know. Maybe we'll be starting a game two after the music, because it looks like the calls there's no more people on the lines right now. We'll take a music break, and then we'll see what's happening. Who sings it? Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Chad.
Hello. Who am I talking to?
Richard.
Hey, Richard. How you doing?
Not too bad, you?
Well, I'm great. You ready for your question?
Yeah, I'll give it a shot.
All right. What is the name of the fictional espionage and law enforcement agency whose most persistent enemy is the criminal organization Hydra?
Hydra. Chaos?
No, that's not bad. Chaos. Do you think they know or they don't know?
I don't think they know.
You don't think they know. All right. What do you think, guys?
Okay, I'm going with S.H.I.E.L.D.
And Ron?
S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah, it was S.H.I.E.L.D. Sorry, sorry, Richard.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, thanks, Chad.
Take care.
Bye.
It's actually an acronym, and the acronym is...
Strategic Homeland.
Yeah, but it's changed. Yeah. It's different than when it was originally came out. All right, let's take another player. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Chad.
Hello.
Hi.
Your name escapes me for a second.
It's Barb.
Oh, Barb.
Yeah. I'm from Quail.
Oh, okay. Yes, we've talked before.
Oh, yes, we have.
usually Doug monopolizes Quail. He's the only one that calls me from
there. I know.
Well, it's good to hear from you now.
I listen to you, but I don't call a lot.
All right. I'm glad you called tonight.
Okay. I know the song. That's why.
Okay, well keep that as an extra point. I'm gonna give you your question first. All right.
Sounds good.
Which actor was the first to play the Joker in a theatrical film?
Oh, geez. It wasn't Jack Nicholson. I'm trying to think. I'm gonna go to the experts.
You're gonna are you gonna bet that they know?
Yeah.
All right. What do you think, guys?
I'm going to go with, I'm going to take a gamble because this was a really trick question. I was really pondering it. And I'm going to go with Cesar Romero because they did do a movie back
in
the 60s.
Yeah, I think so. Cesar Romero is the correct answer.
Right.
Way to go, Barb.
And was that Timbuk 3?
It was Timbuk 3 the extra point. Barb, your last name again?
Aswell. Atwell.
Awesome.
All right, thanks, Chad.
Take care.
Before you continue, Chad, I'd like really like to know what was Ron's answer to that one.
What was your answer, Ron?
Jack Nicholson.
Jack Nicholson?
Booyah.
Well, he was I thought about it.
Booyah. Yeah. Take that.
Yeah, because they actually, after the first season of the television Batman, there was a theatrical movie that came out that summer, which was made to advertise the show.
Yeah.
But it was actually released in theaters.
Yeah, so. Because it had all the four villains.
Yeah, it had all four villains and the same actors.
Cesar Romero, Burgess Meredith.
And
Frank Gersh.
I'm trying to think of the guy who played Batman now.
Adam West.
Yes, he's on Family Guy now. Yeah. All right, are we out of players? Is there anybody who hasn't played yet that would like to play? 819-683-3155 or 56. It looks like I got about 16 questions here. And if not, it'll be a fight for the phones who can get through. Going once, going twice. All right, game one is over. Whoever can get through on these next 15 questions get to play again. So it's a brand new slate. Doesn't matter if you've already played, but you can only play one more time. Again, the number is 819-683-3155 or 56. And I think we're going to go for broke here. No more music breaks. We'll just go until we're done the question.
You're relying on our skills.
Yes.
Oh, boy.
All right. Let's go to the first player in the second game. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hello again.
Hey, Kathy. How are you?
Good, you?
I'm great.
That's good.
Are you enjoying the show?
Yeah.
All right. Here's your question.
All right.
Who is Mega City 1's most famous resident with the power not only to enforce the law, but also to instantly convict and sentence offenders and occasionally execute them?
I have not a clue.
Are you going to bet the guys know or they don't know?
I'll say they don't.
All right. I think we'll probably get some more people taking chances now that we're in game two.
So let her son decide this one. Go ahead.
What do you think?
Now, Roddy, you'd be nice.
Well, Ron, did he have an answer written, Ron?
No.
Okay. All right.
This one completely escaped
me. You're stumped on that one.
I'm going to go with a gamble here.
All right.
Judge Dredd.
Sorry, Kathy. All he right. got it.
Right. Brother-in-law knows best.
We'll see.
All right. Thanks,
Randy.
No problem.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
And first, I think that's the first time that, oh no, it's not the first. That's third or fourth time now that they bet against you. And,
yeah, say you don't bet against this guy.
Oh boy. All right, let's take another player. Good evening, you're on the air.
Hi, Chad.
Hello, Raymond.
Yeah.
Ready for another question?
Yeah, ready for another question, yeah.
All right, in 2005, which superhero discovered that he had a son named Dakin, or Dakin, I'm not quite sure how you pronounce that, who has been brainwashed and made into a living weapon by the villain Romulus, the man behind his own brainwashing?
I don't know.
Any guesses?
I don't know.
No guesses?
No.
You bet that they know or they don't know?
I'm going to bet that they don't know.
All right, they're betting against you. What do you think, Ron?
Ron? We got to save him here.
I'm screwing with you. I'm looking at you and saying Ron.
I'd say Wolverine.
Wolverine is correct. Yeah. Sorry, Raymond, that's a twice now. You're not lucky tonight.
No, I thought I got a point earlier.
Oh, you got a point earlier for what?
Oh, it was with...
I don't think you got it, Raymond.
Oh.
Oh, wait a minute. Maybe you did. I lost the sheet here.
Oh.
I don't see your name here, Raymond.
Oh, right.
I'll check the logs, but I don't think you got one earlier. No.
Your 6:30 song?
Yeah.
Buddy Knox?
Buddy Knox. Well, you got a point there for sure.
Yeah, all right.
All right.
Thank you.
Hey, you're welcome, Raymond.
Yeah. Maybe I'll get a song later.
Is Ivy playing?
Yeah. Here's Ivy.
All right.
Hi, Chad.
Hello, Ivy.
I want to compliment you on reading the questions nice and thoroughly and clear.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah. And the guys, too, there. I want to thank them for doing their best.
Oh,
well,
thank you.
I got to say, I wrote all my own questions tonight.
Oh, good for you.
Yeah.
You need a good tap on the back.
That's probably why I'm speaking. I'm doing it a little bit better because half the time I'm just reading it off a card.
Oh,
so I put the questions together myself.
Good.
You ready for yours?
Yes.
All right. Becoming fed up with the politics and practices of the Justice League, who formed the Outsiders to have his own unit perform on his own terms?
Dr. Doom?
Dr. Doom. That's incorrect. Are you going to bet that they know or they don't know?
Oh, I think they know this one.
All right. Who do we go
my
with?
My fingers
this
and my toes
I'm
are
I'm going to go with Batman.
And Batman. Ron concurs. It is Batman.
Oh, good. So
there you go. You get 2 points for that, Ivy.
He's writing down B-A-T-M-A-N.
What's that?
I think all the music questions have been answered now.
Everything was answered.
That's good. Cleaned it up good.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Take care.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yes, we will try another one.
All right. What was the name of the solar-powered evil clone of Superman in Superman 4, The Quest for Peace?
Well, I can't remember that one.
No?
No.
You bet that they know or they don't know?
Oh, definitely.
They know?
Yes.
All right.
I'm going to go with the Nuclear Man.
And you concur, Ron? Yeah, Nuclear Man for another 2 points, Elmer.
Good enough.
They've been doing good for you
yeah.
Tonight.
Let's hope they do the same for Violet.
Okay, I'll try my best.
Thanks, Ron.
Hello, Chad.
Hello, Violet. I got a question right up your alley here.
Yeah?
Here it is. Which supervillain was introduced in X-Factor as a 5,000-year-old mutant obsessed with the social Darwinist philosophy of survival of the fittest and employs highly advanced technology in his schemes?
Chad Burkle.
No, I wouldn't trust Elmer on that one there, Violet.
I don't know.
You don't know. Do you bet that they know or they don't know?
Oh, definitely they know.
You think they know? I don't know. No. We'll see.
Okay.
All right, we'll start with Ron this time.
I think it's Apocalypse.
I'm going Apocalypse as well.
Apocalypse is correct, Violet. There you go. You get 2 points for that.
Okay, thanks, Chad.
Take care.
And good evening to you all there.
Thank you kindly.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye. And good evening. You're on the air.
Hey, Chad.
Hey, Carl. Somebody beat you to the song.
Well.
You ready for your question?
Of course.
All right. Which supervillain sought to unravel the mysterious anti-life equation? No clue. All right. Do you bet that they know or they don't know?
They probably do, yeah.
I'm betting that they know. All right. We'll start with you, Randy.
Okay. I'm going through taking a guess here with Darkseid.
Darkseid. And Ron?
Darkseid.
Darkseid is the correct answer. There you go, Carl. 2 points for you.
Thanks a lot, guys.
No problem.
All right. Take care.
Bye now.
Bye-bye. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yes, I'll try again there, Chad.
Hey, you're back.
Yeah.
All right. Which supervillain returned after a long absence in 2007 after being destroyed in the 1985 series Crisis on Infinite Earths, number 12?
I don't know.
You bet that they know or they don't know?
I hope they know.
You're going to bet with them?
Yeah, I'm going to bet with them.
All right, we'll start with Ron.
I think it's Owlman.
Owlman. And
I'm going with the Anti-Monitor.
And it is the Anti-Monitor. And Janine, you get another 2 points.
Oh, good. Thank you very much, Chad.
Well,
and you too, guys. Thank you very much.
All right.
Okay,
take
bye-bye.
Care.
Bye-bye. Uh-oh. I can see the bragging come right now.
Yeah. You got lucky, 15 answers ago, but
oh,
now,
well, you know. All right, got another 8 or 9 questions here. Let's take another call. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Chad. It's Karen.
Hi, Karen. You ready for your question?
I sure am.
I got one right up your alley here.
Okay.
Which Titanian or Eternal supervillain gained control of the Infinity Gauntlet, which gave him the power to destroy half the life in the universe by simply snapping his fingers?
Oh, yeah, that's right up my alley. I don't have a clue.
Do you bet that Randy and Ron know or they don't know?
I hope they know. They did me good before.
All right, they're going with you guys.
Oh, boy. Okay, I'm going, I'm going to go with Atlas.
Atlas? Oh. And Ron?
Name slips my mind.
That's a good name. That's a good character.
I'm afraid Atlas is not the correct answer.
Oh.
Is it Kronos, Thanos, or the Beyonder?
I would say it's Thanos.
Thanos?
Yeah, I'll go with Thanos.
Thanos is correct.
Yeah, Ronnie came to the rescue this
time. So there you go. You get the point there, Karen.
Okay, here's Rail.
I knew it started with a T.
Oh, good for you.
Hey, Dad. Hi, Rail. How are you? You ready for your question?
Yeah.
And there we go. I think this relates back to a question we had a while ago about Mr. Terrific, and he was actually one of the choices here. What is Mr. Fantastic's real name?
Mr. Terrific.
Mr. Terrific, no. You bet that they know or they don't know?
They know.
Yeah, I think they know.
They
know.
The last time they know.
We're going to go with, Reed Richards.
Reed Richards, yeah, part of the Fantastic Four. So there you go, Real. You got 2 points for that.
All right, thanks.
All right, thanks for playing.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Let's take another call. Good evening, you're on the air.
Hi, Chad. It's Chad and the lads. It's
yeah.
Collins again.
Hi, Ian. Ready for your question?
I sure am.
Which incarnation of the Flash contracted a mysterious disease where the more he used his speed powers, the faster his body would die?
I'm not even understanding
incarnation. Which version, basically? There's been more than one person that put on the Flash costume.
Oh, okay. Number four.
No. I need a name.
Okay,
and there was, by the way, there was only three. If you don't count if you only count like the regular canon.
Yeah,
Flash.
There's
not,
only three.
Yeah,
okay,
but I mean, it's more than three if you count like the alternate versions, Earth 2 and that kind of thing. But there's only three main ones. Yeah, no, it's not George. Did you say George?
I did say George.
No, it's not George. Do you want to bet that the guys know or they don't know?
Oh, I believe that the lads will know.
All right, what do you guys think?
Okay, I'm going to go with Barry Allen.
Barry Allen is wrong.
Ooh.
But you knocked off one of the choices, which is good. So it's either Jay Garrick or Wally West.
Who's got a coin?
Which one do you
say? Jay Garrick.
Jay Garrick, Ron says.
Yeah, I'll go with Jay Garrick.
And what do you think, Ian?
Yeah, Wally West sounds just too stupid, so I'll go with the other one.
No, well, it was Wally West.
Was it really?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Yeah, I remember that now.
Oh, now you remember.
Yeah, now he remembers. So.
Now he remembers. Yeah. Okay, I'll remember that.
Remember, that was Ron that said that and not Randy?
Okay. And here's Cheryl.
All right.
I'm sorry, Chad.
Hi, Cheryl.
How are you tonight again?
Oh, I'm great.
That was a great show.
Well, here's another question for you.
Okay.
The Dire Wraiths are an evolutionary offshoot of which race of extraterrestrial shapeshifters?
Oh, gosh, I'm going to have to ask Randy.
Well, you want to bet whether they
I bet with Randy.
You bet with Randy and Ron. Okay, Randy, she's going with you. Who do you think?
I'm going to go with Skrulls.
Skrulls.
The Skrulls is correct for 2 points.
Oh, that's 6 points I got tonight, Chad.
Yeah, you did well.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, I heard that.
Remember, that was Ron's fault the last time.
We'll call you soon for a song.
All right, thanks.
Bye now.
Bye-bye. Good evening, you're on the air.
Good evening, Chad.
Hi, Doug, back again.
Yes, try again.
All right. Which DC supervillain uses a variety of toxins that causes victims to hallucinate that their phobias have come to life.
Hmm. Weirdo man.
Weirdo man. You should be a writer.
Well, yeah.
You could get past Randy some ideas for villains here.
If Randy could do it, anybody can do it, okay?
I think the guys should know that one.
You're going to bet with Randy and Ron?
Yeah.
All right. What do you think, Randy or Ron?
I'm going to go anyway with Scarecrow.
Scarecrow.
Scarecrow is the correct answer, Doug.
All right.
Hey, thanks for playing.
Okay, thank you. I'll pass it to Joanne.
All right.
Here we go again.
Hi, Joanne. Here's your question. Which superhero member of the Avengers first appeared in Journey into Mystery number 83?
Oh, I don't think I know that one.
Do you think they know?
I think so.
All right. We'll start with Ron this time.
I think it's Wasp.
And Randy?
I think it's Thor.
It is Thor. And then you got 2 points for that, Joanne.
Good. Have a good evening.
You too.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye-bye. That's like two there recently. That's
yeah, well,
talk.
See, you're sinking.
Uh-oh. All right, we got a few. We got about, let's see, one, two, three questions left here. So we'll
if he gets the next one wrong, he's paying for the gas on the way back home.
All right.
Well, you got a problem then.
Good evening. You're on the air.
At Ron and Randy.
Hi, Stan. You didn't do so well last time,
right? No, not too good.
All right, we're going to try this time and see what happens.
Good.
Who was the first black superhero in mainstream American comics?
His first name, maybe Alex?
No, afraid not.
No.
Do you bet that they know or they don't know?
Well, I'm sure they would know that one.
Okay. What do you think?
I'm going with Black Lightning.
And Ron?
Luke Cage.
No. Well, you knocked off one of the choices I had. I had actually Black Lightning as one of the choices here. So okay. It's either the Falcon or Black Panther.
Black Panther.
You're going with Black Panther. What do you think, Randy?
I think it's Falcon.
You think it's Falcon?
Actually, I think I'm going to go with Black Panther.
Are you going to keep your answer Black Panther, Stan?
Yes.
It is Black Panther. Oh, man.
How much change
all right,
in the
there you go. You get a point. You finally get a point, Stan.
Good. Thank you, Kat. Have a good weekend.
You take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.
I only have two questions left. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Chad.
Two questions, two players. Works out perfectly.
Yeah.
All right. You ready?
I think so.
All right. Which Spider-Man goblin villains... Oh, sorry. I didn't read that right. Which Spider-Man goblin's villain's long-held secret identity was Roderick Kingsley?
I don't know. Not a clue.
Do you bet
Spider Woman,
Do you bet that they know or they don't know?
I think they do know.
All right, we'll go
Hobgoblin.
Hobgoblin.
Hobgoblin, yeah. Hobgoblin is the correct answer for 2 points, Donna.
Thanks again, guys.
No problem. That's what we're here for.
Have a great weekend.
You too.
Thanks.
Bye-bye. And the last question of the night. Last question of the night. Oh, man.
Okay, make it an easy one.
Well, it goes to you, the Duke of Golden Lake.
Well.
All right. Who invoked the magic phrase Inukchuk to grow 50 feet in size?
Well, yes. 50 feet in size. Hercules?
Hercules. No, not Hercules. Are you going to bet that Randy and Ron know, or are you going to bet that they don't know?
Oh, they helped me last time. Let's go along with it.
All right, we'll start with Ron. Give Ron one last chance here.
Come on, Ron.
Shazam.
Not Shazam. No. Randy, last chance.
I'm going to go with the Apache Chief.
Apache Chief is correct.
There you go.
No problem. Good thing you did the pet on Ron on that one, did you?
Well, thank you very much, Archie. Well, I can't blame Ron for not knowing that's way before his time.
Now you're trying to just say that just because I just turned 36, is that what you're trying to say? Okay. All right.
Okay, well, thank you very much, and you guys have a great weekend.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks
you
for playing.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. And there we go. We've done 62 questions, and that's it for Superhero. What did you think of the caliber of questions this time?
Oh, interesting. It was quite well organized and everything.
Would you want them to be tougher next time?
They did pretty good. We do have to keep some of our pride here.
Do you want me to go more obscure next time, or keep it about the same level?
Yeah, same level. A little mix. Get us thinking out of the box.
All right. Yeah. All right.
If you want to email the answers about 2 weeks ahead of time, I'd appreciate it.
Well, I can't do that. Okay. Can't even give you the questions because you could probably look them up easily.
Oh,
yeah. So,
oh, it was great. And, all right. Just probably to give a little special note to thank your listeners because they played a huge part in the book sales and passing the word around and even seeing people like, you know, all over the county, actually. And like, you know, even in Pontiac County and Renfrew County and just even people around. Like even send me emails congratulating me, wishing me support, and that's a big deal because you know, sometimes you start wondering if you really you know have a good story or do you really have what it takes or you know there's you know we all have that point that we just sometimes saying well maybe I'm in the wrong business or something like that. But when you have people out there just saying you know hey great story you know you're doing great we're loving it we can't wait for the next story it is a really build up you know and I would thank you all from the bottom of my heart.
Well, it's great having you and it's fun doing these collaborative shows. I've been trying to get other people in mm-hmm. and to do the same sort of thing, mm-hmm. but with different categories. The only thing is, with superheroes is a subject I love. Yeah. You know, so yeah. it's easy yeah. to come up with these questions, yeah. and other categories might not be as easy. But it's fun to have to work on mm-hmm. this because I know my audience. You know, mm-hmm. as you saw tonight, there wasn't too many. We got two answers, I think, yeah. from on this. They got it on the spot.
Yeah.
Turok and then Cheryl got yeah. the fact that Perry Mason yeah. was first introduced in the radio.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
other than that, I don't think we got anybody that yeah. got it on the spot. So, yeah. You know, I can't do a show like this yeah. other without help mm-hmm. from people like you. So, awesome. All right, so we'll have to do it again sometime.
Oh, for sure.
Superheroes 3.
Yeah.
Sometime maybe this summer. Summer's yeah. coming up. We'll yeah. Maybe we'll get together and I'll have to think of more challenging questions because some of them you just answered way too easily, I think. I was amazed by how you came up with the answer. So. All right, so we're going to take some requests now for or suggestions for music. 819-683-3155 or 819-683-3156. You don't mind sticking around just while I get get this in? All right. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Chad.
Hello, Raymond.
Superheroes 3 sounds good.
All right.
Can't wait. Yeah.
Cool.
Kiss.
Okay.
Shout it out loud.
Shout it out loud. All right.
All right. Are you going to watch the game when you get home?
Most likely.
But
you say Chicago's going to win, so I don't know.
No, Vancouver's going to win.
Oh, you're changing your prediction now. You said didn't he say Chicago was going to win?
Yeah, but he's agreeing with me now.
I was drafting it because you said it was Vancouver, and then because you said Vancouver twice, and I said no, they're playing Chicago.
Okay, so you're betting that Vancouver is going to win tonight?
Yeah, they should win, yeah.
All right.
All right, right. Thank you.
You're 2-for-2. Well, let's see if yep. you're 3-for-3.
We'll see you in 3-for-3, yeah.
All right.
Have a nice weekend.
You too.
You like.
Hi, Chad.
Hello.
I just want to compliment the guys and you two for putting it all together. And Randy knows some stuff because he's completely immersed in it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I guess he has to know about. Oh, yeah. You have to know what's out there, so you know you don't accidentally recreate something,
yeah,
right?
Or copy it,
if
or
the people,
you know.
People interested in it, like the.
I've got an idea from a superhero that comes from a doomed world, and when he reaches our world, the sun gives him special powers. And, yeah. Oh, wait a minute.
Come on, that's so Batman. Come on.
What would you like to hear, Ivy?
I'm going with the Rolling Stones.
Okay.
Brown Sugar.
Brown Sugar. All right, okay. Thanks for playing.
You're welcome.
Or calling.
Yeah, it was fun.
All right.
Okay. Bye-bye.
And good evening, you're on the air.
Good evening, Chad, Randy, and Ron. It's Ian speaking again.
Hi, Ian.
Great show.
Well, thanks.
Wonderful show. Thank you, Chad, for compiling, and thanks for the knowledge of the two lads there.
Mm-hmm. They're smart.
Yes, they are. They know their genre, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Thank you.
How about Lowrider by War?
That sounds like a good song to me.
And I'd like to put that out to our good friend Sean Warren.
All right.
I think he's probably got his ears on.
Yeah, he was anxious to play a second time, but unfortunately, he couldn't.
Yeah, I heard that, but he's like everybody else. You have to follow the rules.
But he got on tonight. He got points on. He got a point at least on the board, thanks to, I think, Randy and Ron. So
perfect.
Glad he got to play tonight.
The only reason I got on was because of Randy and Ron. That's cool, too.
All right.
Okay, well, thanks so much, pal.
Take care.
You bet.
And good evening. You're on the air.
Hey, Chad. How you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
Not too bad. I don't remember the singer or the group, but it's the song Santeria.
Santa Maria by the Trooper?
No.
Santeria. Oh.
It's on the Guitar Hero.
It's on what?
The Guitar Hero for the Wii.
Oh.
But I can't remember the...
Santeria. No, I've got the Santa Maria by... I think it's by Trooper, but Santeria. No, I don't have that.
That Trooper one. I like Trooper.
Santeria. Wait a minute. Maybe I'm spelling it wrong. Hold on. I'll just check one more place, because I was spelling it... I was spelling it different than Google is giving it to me. No, I still don't have it. I do. Yeah, Santeria by Sublime.
That's it. Yeah, Sublime, yes.
All right, there we go.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Take care.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. And good evening. You're on the air. Hi, Sean.
How are you doing?
I'm great.
Great?
Yeah, how are you?
Good.
All right, on.
Sean?
Yeah, Sean.
Let me tell you something.
Go ahead.
Please. To me, she was here yesterday.
She was there yesterday?
Yes.
Okay.
Alec comes down with you to have some in the summer.
Okay.
I mean, Chris. Chris, you song.
Okay, you want to request a song?
Yes.
Okay, what would you like?
Would you tell me one, Chad?
Oh, would I help you with one? Sure.
Please?
Yeah. Maybe Randy can help. You know a good rock song we could play for Sean?
Yes.
Do you like AC/DC? Okay, let's go with Thunderstruck. All right. Awesome.
All right. All right. Yes?
Would you play my first jam for me?
Okay. I can do that.
You a woman?
Okay. Are you with Dan tonight?
Yes.
Would Dan like a song too?
Yes.
All right, let me talk to Dan then.
Don't hang up.
I won't hang up.
I think Sean has some awesome taste. That's right. Awesome.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Sean.
Take care.
Hi, Chad.
Hi, Dan.
You have a Five Finger Death Punch. I forget the name of the song.
Bad Company?
I've got Never Enough or The Bleeding.
Never Enough.
All right.
Well, good band, good band.
Cool. Thanks, Dan.
All right. Have a good night.
You too. And good evening. You're on the air.
Hey, Chad.
Hi, Carl.
How about some Steppenwolf?
Sure.
Magic Carpet Ride?
Yeah.
And by the way, Randy, I'm halfway through the Resurgence, and it is very, very interesting.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
All right.
Thank you for your support.
All right.
Take care, Carl.
Okay. Bye now.
Bye. And good evening, you're on the air.
Hey, Chad, it's Rael.
Hi, Rael.
Sean got an AC/DC, did he?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go with something different.
Okay.
Spaceship Superstar, Prism.
All right.
And are you drawing the book tonight, or?
I'm going to do the draw, but I'm going to announce the winners on Monday.
Oh, that's great.
Is that okay? Just in case some people are not listening, like from the beginning of the show, and they might miss their name being drawn. I'll announce the winners on Monday. If that's okay with you guys?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah,
awesome.
Right.
That Prism one, there's no live version.
I'll check. I just have the regular version. Sorry.
Okay, it's good enough.
All right.
Okay. Bye bye.
You too.
Bye.
Bye. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Chad. It's Barb again from Quail.
Hi, Barb.
Hi. Can I hear any Slade song?
What kind of song?
Slade.
Slade, yeah, we can play. I'm sure we can play. Oh, I only have one song.
Oh, do you? Okay, what do you got?
Run Away.
Okay, it's good enough.
All right.
All right, thanks a lot.
Take care.
Bye.
All right, you can continue calling me off the air. I don't know. What would be a fitting song for tonight? Something like maybe Kryptonite or something?
Yeah, that'd be good. Yeah.
Go with Kryptonite. All right. Thanks again, guys. It was awesome having you here. I can't thank you enough. Thank you for having us.
It
really made the show. And
thank you and your listeners. You know, you guys are the best. And, you know, I love you all. And I had a blast and want to do this again.
All right.
All right.
Here's Three Doors Down with Kryptonite. I got room for maybe one more song, so if you haven't had a song yet tonight, call me up because I'm all out of time almost. And this one is going out to Randy and Ron, who are on their way home after spending a great night here playing trivia with us. I hope they fare well on their ride home. They wanted a song to get them there, so let's get that on there right now. Here's Kansas with Carry On Wayward Son.
Still was a